Hey guys, so it is officially October, which also means it's officially fall in my mind. So today I'm going to be doing a fall get ready with me. So let's get to it. I did not wet my beauty blender. I have to go all the way downstairs just to wet it because there's no water up here. I'll be right back. Okay, so I am back with my Real Techniques sponge. I am going to start with the Maybelline Fit Me Dewy and Smooth. I get really dry skin, especially in the fall and winter months, so that's why I like to do dewy, because it just isn't going to mattify to my skin and it's not going to cling onto the dry spots as much, and that's also why I like to use the Beauty Blender. It just kind of helps with that. So let's go ahead and put it on my hand. And I'm in the shade, it's on the lid, I'm on the shade 125 Nude Beige. This is kind of my tan color, so it might not match my neck because I have lost my tan. So use this side for the foundation. I like to use this because it gets right into the corner of my eye. Don't forget your ears either, because you don't want that to be not matching either. Gosh, I totally have this new primer I was going to try, the e.l.f. Tone Adjusting Face Primer, and I totally forgot. I haven't been using primer all summer, really haven't been wearing a whole lot of makeup all summer, so I just haven't been using it, so I completely forgot. But okay, so I got the foundation, and now I'm going to go in with concealer. Usually I use the Master Conceal by Face Studio Maybelline, but today I'm going to do the one that matches the concealer, or the foundation that I did. So I'm going to be doing the Fit Me Concealer, and this is in the shade 26. And now I use the flat side for this, just because I want to do it where it's still kind of moist. I kind of use the moisture out of the other side. I didn't realize how uncomfortable this position was going to be on my back. Oh well. I want to make sure I get in the corner of my eyes because I have a lot of discoloration there. People do their eyebrows first and their eyeshadow first. Typically, sometimes I do like to do my eyeshadow first, but I almost always forget. Oh god, oh my god.
What happened to anyone else that get it, like, on their eyeball?
It's probably just me. Okay, that looks pretty blended to me. I'm also going to cream contour today, and I'm going to be using just a darker shade of that Fit Me concealer. This is in the 30 Cafe, and I like doing this just because sometimes my powder looks kind of splotchy, and that's probably just the powder I'm using, but I kind of like doing this underneath because I feel like it gives it more of an even contour, whatever you call it. So from there, oh, let's just do this. Sometimes dries fast, so I do it separately, and I'll just use my Beauty Blender. And I know sometimes the bronzy look is more of like a summer look, but I still like to do it in the fall just because I am getting paler. I don't want to be super pale. So that's why I like doing it in the fall. Also, cream contour is good for the fall too, because if you're anything like me and you have dry skin, powder can cling to it. The dry skin, whereas the liquid doesn't. So now I'm going to set my face, and I have been loving the Laura Mercier. Do you pronounce that R at the end? I don't know. I'm in love with this stuff. I was using the e.l.f. HD finishing powder, but I love this one because even though it does kind of mattify the skin, it does not cling to the dry skin whatsoever, and so I really love that, and I'll just use my Beauty Blender again this time. I'll just take a Real Technique brush and wipe it off. Okay, my legs are killing me. I'm gonna fall asleep. I need to walk around. Okay, I'm back. That's powder contour. I'm gonna do that before my eyeshadow just because. So for contour, I'm gonna be using the NYX Highlight and Contour Pro Palette. I've been using this for a few years now. So I'm just gonna go in. That shade is obviously one I use the most. Same with the yellow powder, but ever since I got the Ever since I got that, I don't really use the banana powder in here. So I'm just gonna go in with that. Pull it off and let me just say, it's hard to do YouTube when you're at home because you don't just have to answer to yourself. You also have to answer to your parents, even though you're 23. It's what you get for living at home, taking a break from college. Anyway, so I'm going to finish this face makeup. I'm going to have to film my eye makeup when we get back. So we're going to pause. I'll be back. Okay, so I'm back, and I zoomed you in so you can see my eye look as I do it. I am going to be using the Morphe Kathleen Lights palette. I am literally obsessed with this. The pigmentation, the colors, the long-lastingness of it. I don't even know if that's a word. It's great. I love it. But I also set it with the Laura Mercier, whatever powder. Okay. So, let's start with the transition color. I'm going to be using this middle top shade right here. And I'm using a Luxie 205 tapered blending brush. Now we're going to be going in with this bottom brown shade, and we are going to be using the Luxie 237 blending brush. And this is kind of a smaller brush, so you can get right into the corner. It's going to require a lot of blending, so I'm going back in with that lighter shade brush without putting more product on it, but just going over that to blend it. Okay, so now I'm going to be using this e.l.f. Painter eyeshadow pot, a smudge pot, in the shade Brownie Points. just gonna use a flat hot brush, just go right into it. Okay, and that's a little darker than we want it to be. And also this is kind of more liquidy. It's not like a liquid, but more of a wet formula, I guess you could say. So I'm gonna go over it with this shimmery shade just to brighten it up and set it and so it won't crease. And I'm just gonna use the other side of the same brush. I haven't done my eyebrows yet, so I'm guessing I'm gonna be doing that last. But yeah, there we go. Now I'm just going to do the other eye really quick. Okay, so now I'm going to be doing the bottom lash. And I'm going to take this little, it's like a C brush. It's very, very, very little. And I'm going to go in with that first light color. And just go under the eye. Before I do the mascara, I'm going to go in with the eyebrows, and I'm going to be using the Brow Stylist Definer by L'Oreal Paris in the shade Brunette, and I'm going to take the spoolie. My eyebrows are literally ridiculous. I had to pluck them so bad, but I'm letting them grow out so I can kind of wait to reshape them and see, because I kind of over plucked a little bit last time, and I always pluck my own eyebrows. I just know that I really like it that way, and if I'm the one that messes it up, it makes me feel better. Also, this is almost gone, so I'm going to need another one. And I'm going to set that with the Maybelline Brow Drama Sculpting Brow Mascara in the shade Soft Brown. Okay, so on to the mascara. I'm just going to curl them and then use the Voluminous Million Lashes by... I want to say it's L'Oreal. I honestly don't know. I always just look in the aisles until I see the gold color. Try not to make that typical mascara face.
My feet kept falling asleep, so I walked around.
Actually, I'm gonna do some inner corner highlight and then highlight on my face. I think we'll be done. So, I didn't bring an inner corner eye color shade brush, so I'm just gonna, actually I have this one here. It's kind of a little bigger of an end than I would want, but whatever. And I'm just gonna take I just dipped my finger in that polish. Why? It's okay. So yeah, I'm gonna take this color. Okay, I'm gonna go in with my Marc Jacobs Do You Dewdrops Coconut Gel Highlighter.
Wah, wah, wah.
I think this is a highlight fail. Gonna go in with my Ofra Cosmetics Highlighter Beverly Hills highlighter palette thing. I'm gonna go in with this e.l.f. blush brush. And I'm just gonna go in those two, like the goldish tan colors. Okay, so I actually decided to go without liquid lipstick. Sorry beforehand, the other shots, I was kind of out of it a little, and this light being on really kind of washed out my face, so sorry if you really couldn't see how the look was coming out, but anyways, here's the final look. My feet are falling asleep for sure.
You can stop doing that anytime now. I know it feels soft on your face, but come on. Stop it. No, you're not gonna stop? Okay, well, fine.